our treatment modalities for erectile dysfunction are based on the etiology. Is it psychological? You said the psychiatrist, hormonal. You, if it's low testosterone, you give testosterone. Neurological, treat the nerve disorder. Arteriogenic, lack of blood, then you find a way to improve the blood supply to the penis. Veno-occlusive, meaning venogenic erectile dysfunction, I mentioned to you earlier. Testosterone deficiency is a cause. And multifactorial, do not forget that many of the patients are not, they don't fit into 1, 2, 3, like they come in combinations. So remember, they may have one or more of the factors. Now, the talk is on what are the new options available. Well, the first option which is available is not new, but nobody uses it, nobody practices it very much actually, is that lifestyle modification and better health care and preventive medicine is the key to better sexual function. So all of you must learn to tell your patient in the clinic how to live a more healthy life. For example, do not go to medical conferences and eat at the dinner every time so much. That's the first thing you must tell your patient if he's a doctor. Don't attend medical conferences just to eat at the dinner. And then don't sit there the whole day and don't exercise. These are things. Now, the second thing is androgen therapy. Now, we have shown you that androgen adequacy is very important for sexual life, for the cardiovascular system, and for the prevention of metabolic syndrome. So that's why you must check testosterone in the male who is at risk. Thirdly, there were new central and peripheral pharmacological agents being developed. Now, you all remember the old days when we had a drug, they said to take it, then it was on the paraventricular nucleus, and then you could have erection. But then the new drug caused a lot of giddiness and so forth, so it went out the window. But today, we have a new drug called flibanserin, which is used to treat central caused sexual dysfunction in women. I was part of the committee that developed this drug. And when we were testing it out, although it was developed for women, flibanserin is called the pink Viagra or the new Viagra for women. You know. But it's not arrived in Asia, but it's available in the USA right now. It's produced by a company called AbbVie. You know, and you give it to them, and the woman then has got tremendous sexual drive. When we were doing the test, we found it also works in men. So it is a form of treatment that you can give that will have central action to restore libido in men as well. Although the efficacy in men is about half that of women only, but it's also a method of improving central causes of erectile dysfunction. Now, what is less commonly known is that shortwave treatment can actually improve erectile dysfunction. We have a machine, it's about the size of this podium thing that I'm lecturing in, where you have a shockwave head, you put onto the penis and you just shock it, and then you improve arteriogenic erectile dysfunction. If the ED is caused by lack of blood supply, it will restore blood function. So this is a new therapy. In the whole of Vietnam, I think there are 2 machines right now. And I think it will only get more. I started the first shortwave 3 years ago in Singapore. And by the end of 1 year, we had 7 machines in the country. And we are only a small red dot. Vietnam is 1 million red dots. So you will have 1 million machines. So this machine actually works. It's painless, not painful at all. And I think that's the new way that's coming on to Vietnam. Then I will show you new operations that can treat ED. I've actually developed one new operation I will show you later. And then there are some new inserts and implants that arrive on the scene. But what is more effective for the ultimate cure for ED is stem cell and gene therapy. So if you can develop the stem cell and the gene therapy, you can make the thing work once again, like new. And tissue engineering. But I'm afraid we are in Asia, we haven't got all the big money like Israel has got and USA has got to spend on research. So we leave it to them to do the research, and then we'll benefit when they have developed. So in the meantime, item A to D is what is available or going to be available in Hanoi, in the whole of Vietnam and the rest of Asia. I think my sexy young friend here has got a machine, or two machines in this hospital. So if you can't find it in Hanoi, go to Ho Chi Minh, they got two there. Now, for ordinary practitioners, the GPs, the ordinary practitioner, when you don't have such high-tech things, your first line of therapy has always been the use of oral PDE5 inhibitor. So it still holds true, this is the first line. The tried and tested Viagra, Levitra, Cialis have been around for more than 15 years. Some new ones are coming on, and I'll show you some new ones. And the latest one that I will be starting to prescribe end of this year is called Speedra, that you can take it and within 10-15 minutes is working. Now, the second line therapy, yeah, all of you know about it also. When all these oral medicines don't work, you can use vacuum suction device, injections or inserts. There's also a new insert that just come out, and I will show you the insert later also. And the third line therapy would be penile implants, vascular surgery, for example, arterial revascularization, and venous leak surgery, of which I developed a new venous leak operation I will show you later. This is quite good when it first came out. The daily 5 mg low dose Cialis was quite useful. It was a good advance in the treatment of erectile dysfunction, because you just take it a small tablet every day, and then your erection comes back to normal. You don't have to take it every day just before the action, you know. So it becomes a bit embarrassing, you know, when you have to take it and they say, your wife asks you, or your girlfriend asks you, shall we do it? Then you say, hey, hold on, let me take my tablet before we can do it 1 hour. Wait for 1 hour, can or not? We watch TV 1 hour, I come back, you know. So with this new drug, it was quite comfortable for men not to be embarrassed. Now there's another one, is if you are a party goer, imagine at a party you meet somebody and then the lady tell you, okay, Johnny, let's go for a quickie. And Johnny said, I got to take a tablet, it'll wait me 1 hour. Can you go and drink Coca-Cola 1 hour and I come back? So Viagra, the company making Viagra came up with this oral dispersible tablets, which you just put into your mouth, it just, you know, immediately gets swallowed, and it works quite fast. It wasn't as fast as the new one that's coming out at the end of this year, which will work within 10-15 minutes. So all these new drugs are coming with new things. Unfortunately about these tablets, they are not always effective. They are not always convenient, like I told you just now. And if they do not cure, they only make it happen for you, and then tomorrow you'll take again if you want it to work. Then there was this funny looking thing, it's called a cylinder. You put it there, you pump it up, then it will work, and you're going to put a rubber band at the bottom. It's also very embarrassing and very cumbersome to carry around with you. And of course, this is only now found in sex shops, you know. You know, I don't know whether it's found in Vietnam sex shops, so if you're not sure, you can come with me, you take a walk downtown and have a look, see whether it can be found there, you know. Right, that's how it happens. This is a battery-operated version. There are some versions that you have to use your hand and pump it, you know, with a plunger. Alright? Now, for those who wanted something more daring and very, very efficient to produce an erection, it was this cable jet injection. So it can be supplied like this, so you drop the medication into your syringe, and then you inject by the side of your penis, right? Ouch! You know? And then they get a good erection. Now, I found that the people who go for this are those who are under stress by their female partner. When I was practicing in the United States of America, I had a lot of male patients coming in and say, doctor, I need to have this. I said, why you need to have this? Hey, Viagra will do. And then the man will tell me, no, when my girl wants it, she wants it now. Now, John, you're unable to do it, get out. You know, that kind of threatening way, you know. So the minute the woman shouts at him like that, the fellow everything is, you know, he loses confidence in himself and he cannot function. So the only thing that works for him then is that under those circumstances, you either do it now and get it up, or you get out of my room and get out, I don't want to see you again. That kind of a talk, you know. So the man goes to the toilet, chop like that, it will work immediately with the injection. So they keep coming back to me for injections, you know. It only happens in America, not in Vietnam. Vietnam, the women have to inject themselves rather than the other way around. Am I right? If I'm wrong, tell me later quietly. So this is how they do it. They go to the bathroom, inject themselves and come out. Then they say, okay, Maggie, I'm ready for you. And then Maggie will say, come on, I want it three times tonight or you get out also. This injection will do it. Okay? Now, but then many of them were afraid of the needle. So this company called Alprox TD in the States came up with this. It's a little liquid you just inject when you pass urine. It's not a needle. And then you can get erection within 15 minutes. It's not bad. So the only trouble about this is that after you get your erection, you've done your thing, after you pass urine for about 3 to 6 hours, when you pass urine, you feel a bit burning sensation, but it will disappear. It wasn't that popular because people didn't like the burning sensation. Now, this company actually bought a license to manufacture this in China. They bought the license from this company in USA for $650 million. And they manufactured it in China. And then suddenly they stopped manufacturing. You know why? One patient, or rather somebody did a study and they put this in the rats, you know. They injected into the rats, the urethra. And after a few months, 6 months later, one of the rats developed cancer. So everybody got frightened by it. It only happened to stupid rat, not a human being. But everybody got frightened. So the thing became not very popular. And what happened? The company went bankrupt. They paid $650 for the patent, you know, to manufacture in China, and it went bankrupt. So for 10 years, this thing went out, went away. And then somebody in Japan said, I'll do another one that doesn't cause cancer. So he's produced one, same thing, but the name of the drug is called Vitaros, V-I-P-A-R-O-S. I keep a stock of it in my clinic, so if you want it, I can send it to you. It's not cheap. One pop is 100, it's about $65, sorry. One pop, very expensive. And because it's very temperature sensitive, you must keep it in the refrigerator. The minute you take it into the hot environment, and this room is so hot, you know, gone case, within 1 hour, it's already cannot work. You see. And it costs $65, one pop, one go, the whole thing goes, $65, a lot of money. So that's how you use it. You just open the cap, open the hole there, push it in, that's it. It'll work within 10, 15 minutes, wonderful. No need injection. So, although I don't think any of you have seen it, but I have I'm the only one to keep stock back home. So if you want it, say hello darling to me, and you man, you can say hello darling to me, I'll give you one. Now, okay, now, talk about needle stick. Now, the bugbear of the treatments for erectile dysfunction is veno-occlusive erectile dysfunction. Blood leaks out from the penis. So the operation I've been doing for the last 20 years actually is this operation where we tie up every vein that's leaking. Every vein we tie up. It takes 2 hours to do a long-winded operation and we have to tighten the back here. Alright? So this operation was very troublesome. A lot of people refused to do it. Then, 3 years ago, I read from this Austrian chap called Herwig. He's a radiologist actually. Very smart chap. He said he cannulated the deep dorsal vein of the penis and he shoot in little pellets to embolize the leaking vein. And this is his first series, 96 cases, success with, you know, color, he confirmed with color Doppler ultrasound, you know. So his success is 77%, sorry, 4.1% fail. So quite a good success rate. But it's a very tricky operation, right? What he had to do, he had to do a venogram through the deep dorsal vein of the penis here, cannulated, and then he then injected this thing inside until no more leak, you see. I'll go back to show you. See the leak, this is the leak. Then he injected the pellets inside the bronchi. Then the leak stopped, you see, no more leak. But it's quite painful. All the patients I used to send to him, and the patient complained very painful, and then very inconvenient. So then I said there must be a better way to do it. So now I developed my own method. And instead of injecting these little umbrellas or little pellets, but once I demonstrate the leak here like this, what I do is that through the cannula I inject tissue glue. And as the glue reaches there, it hardens very quickly, it blocks it immediately, and the next thing you do is that you see no more leak. And the patient can go home within a few hours. We have done about 30 oral cases now, and all of them, no recurrence so far. And my follow-up is about 9 months. So if you want to know how to do it, you can come down and we can show you how to do it. Or you can invite one of my people there, a vascular surgeon that one of my vascular surgeons working in my place, very good. He's very good at angiocatheterization. He can do it and show it to you. Now this is the success rate of that guy in Austria. No, I'm just showing you what he did. This is his series, right? Now let's go back to other methods. Now this is a classical penile implant. You know of the classical penile implant. But now there have been improvements to the penile implant. The penile implant has got a lock here that will prevent auto-inflation. The penile implant now has got antibiotic impregnated in its sheath. So all these are the new developments in the penile implant business. The design is to emulate the look and performance of natural erection. So it feels nicer, and the patients actually commented to me, the new generation ones, they feel better. And then they brought their partners, and the partners say like that to me. Like that, you know. So must be good. If the woman say like that, it must be good, you know. If the men say, I don't believe it. I never believe the men. They're all liars. Ladies, you agree? All men are liars. So that's the penile implant. You all know all about it. I won't talk about it. Now, what you do not know is that I created with Professor Brindley, a made in Singapore penile implant. It's a very unusual implant. It's a penile delivery, drug delivery system. So when we came out, the newspapers got heard about it, and then I became famous overnight. So I became a James Bond overnight. Everybody thought I was a damn good, you know. a quarter of the price of the normal penile implant, much smaller and safer. So I show you what it is. We insert inside the implant this drug called sodium natural perchlorate. So each insert is done in the outpatient clinic through a needle lying on the bed, and it will last for 20 erections. So after 20 erections, will come back for me to refill the implant. So that's the place where the drug is stored. You see, at the top there's a glass plate. So when you puncture, your needle will hit the glass plate, so it won't puncture the rubber. And then this part is joined into the penis, so that when you squeeze this thing here, you squeeze this, the drug will go in and you get an erection. So this is x-ray of a person. This is before the squeezing. So you just grab the scrotum, you squeeze it, the drug goes in within less than 10 minutes, that's the erection, you see. Right? He's too shy to show the erection, so we have to take x-ray. Then he doesn't show his face, his penis, you see. Alright? Now, then there's another new thing that come, but it started with the concept of arteriolization of penis. In the old days, if you had arteriogenic erectile dysfunction, we had to create a new artery for your penis. So it was called arteriolization. So how do I do it? I've done lots of this actually. Nobody else does in the south. I think from Taiwan down, nobody does it except me. I think above Taiwan, there are some people doing it. One in Japan and two in China, I think, still doing. You make a cut here, you take the If you have gastric artery, you pull it through this outlet there, and then you join it to the artery of the penis, bypassing the blocked arteries. So it's called arteriolization of the penis. The first operation, it took me 7 hours to do, but now I can do everything in less than 3. The more you do, the faster you are. So this is microsurgery, so you must know microsurgery to do this. But now we have a new thing available now in Ho Chi Minh City and very soon in Hanoi City. Shockwave. Boom! You shock this thing and it will work again. Fantastic. But how does shockwave work? It sounds a bit too far-fetched. The shockwave produces a shearing stress which causes intra and cellular changes which stimulate endothelial nitric oxide synthase. And this leads to a release of vascular endothelial factor. And this will lead to cell nuclear antigen production. And that causes new blood vessels to grow. So the secret of the shockwave is that it makes new blood vessels for your penis without me doing that big operation to show earlier. So wonderful. So people say, well, the shockwave be painful, it's painless. Now, for those of you who are taking exams, your examiner will ask you, what is the mechanism? Low intensity extracorporeal shockwave causes is a non-enzymatically created reaction in the tissues of the penis. This enhances the expression of VEGF and its receptor FLT-1. And because of this, neovascularization is created. All right? And you will see a lot of PCNA expression in the endothelial cell area because of the of this being discharged into the area created by the shockwave. Now this is the shockwave head. It's a small little thing only. This is a nice comfortable cushion that sits on the penis and it causes the penis to feel as if you're having a massage. That's what, boom, 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 boom. You can shoot 1,500 shots. Now this is the machine I'm using, and it's produced by the great country of Israel. Alright? This is the Israeli machine. The first machine to be invented came from Israel. So like everything, go for the original guy. Don't go for the one that come after that. Now, after this became successful, the Germans called the Dornier company came up with this one. This is the Dornier machine. Now let me show you the how this technology started. You know, in urology, we started shockwave for treatment of kidney stones. And you were shooting at the stones at 450 bar of power. Then the orthopedic people realized that shockwave can cure or stop pain. And indeed, that's what I did when I had tennis elbow. I went to play tennis with my girlfriend one day, you know, many years ago, and I got severe tennis elbow pain. So I couldn't go out dating anymore, I could not hold her anymore. So I said, desperate man. So I went to the shockwave machine, I used the shockwave machine, bang, my area there, and it created anti-inflammatory action at 200 bar. And then the tennis elbow pain disappeared immediately. Wonderful. The next invention came when the cardiologist, the cardiac boys, thought that if I were to shock your heart, I can make new blood vessels in your heart so that ischemic heart disease can be improved. So the cardiac voice was shooting at 80 to 100 bar. And finally, this rather intelligent guy, he doesn't look very intelligent by the way, he looks like Lieutenant Colombo, if you get what I mean. You know the story of Lieutenant Colombo? He's a very good detective, but he looks like an idiot, you know, and he is like an idiot, but he's very bright. He makes you think he's an idiot, so that you let go your guard, then he'll catch you. See? So, well, this Israeli urologist, he looks like Lieutenant Colombo, he is like Lieutenant Colombo, but he's very intelligent. So he said, why don't I shoot the penis, man? And then, so he came up with the concept of shockwave for the penis and causing improvement in ED. His contention was that low intensity shockwave can cause revascularization of the penis, has been treated for the past 10 years for chronic ischemia of the heart and etc. So why not use it for the penis? Right? He uses 0.09 millijoules per square millimeter, which is 10 to 15, 18% only of the energy used for shockwave. So only 10% of the energy used for shockwave for the kidney stones. Now this is the penile tissue who has ED, erythromuscularogenic cause. So you shock the vellum, shock. Then you see secretion of angiogenic factors came up. And then you do a picture, an angiogram later on, or you see a lot more new blood vessels appearing. So that's how it works. It's like magic, you know. You don't believe me, it works. Ask a handsome young man here. He has done 300 shockwave cases in Ho Chi Minh City. 300 menu. Makes him a hero of Vietnam. Yes. All the men now will love him. Now, again, those of you don't know what it is, I told you how it works. I think I've shown you this slide. But I have not shown you this one. This is the heart, you know. Look at the heart. There's not much blood vessels in this heart. This patient, the heart, chest pain. You shock the heart, but you see the new blood vessels coming up. So it's not a BS, it's a real thing. Now, major cells involved in this process are the endothelial cells, which line the blood vessels and constitute capillaries. So, from this cartoon, you can see the blood cells here, endothelial cell, it will shoot sprout out side blood vessels coming out. Can you see that? So, I mean, one picture is worth 10 pages of written word. So I'm giving you the picture. Now, for those who are taking exams, you want to show that the shockwave causes a mechanical response. This response causes a shearing stress and cavitation, causing this response which stimulates the release of nitric oxide, VGF, and proliferating cell nuclear antigen, which in the short term causes basal dilatation and increased perfusion and erection. When you are shocking the penis, it rises to say hello to you, which means it's a short-term response. But when they go home on the long term, more blood vessels will form, and then neovascularization occur, and then the ED is cured. It only works for arteriogenic ED. It does not work for venogenic or any neurogenic and the rest. So, indication, bona fide arteriogenic ED. Now this is the literature. If you don't believe me, I have to tell you that these are all the papers in the literature that show this thing is real. Alright? Of course, this just shows you a paper that they reported by Nishida. The Japanese are also very into it in the big way. They tried it in pigs at first, you know, and it seems to work in pigs also and so forth. Now, this is the heart machine. You lie down there and then you just shoot it. You know, Philippines have got the heart machine. So if you have it, you should have it. If you please have it, you better have two. And you lie down there, and this is an echocardiogram. So you monitor with an echocardiogram. You need to have this echocardiogram monitoring, and you do it for the heart. We don't need it for the penis. And this is before and after, you see. This is from my friend in Taiwan, Morgan Fu. I am not a cardiologist, so I don't have a picture. He gave it to me, his picture. You see, after shocking, you see the blood vessel coming out. So we are not giving you a bullshit thing, we are giving you the real deal. Okay, 4 weeks post, you see, control group, you shock the control group, nothing happens. But here you are, the shockwave group, see that? Control group means you put a piece of metal plate to prevent the shockwaves going in. Alright? Improves ejection fraction and stroke volume of the heart. Stopped the severity of the chest pain after a 6-minute walk testing. So it helped chest pain. It can stop all the indoor and all those dangerous drugs. Once you take it, you cannot take Viagra and all those drugs. So you better do this. So the people with repeated chest pain, angina pectoris, ischemia, pain, disease are the ones most suited for it. Now let's go back to my good friend, the Israeli, the Lieutenant Colombo, Professor Y. Yabadi. Yeah, you know what he looks like? He looks like Lieutenant Colombo. Looks rather stupid, but the brain is the brain of a genius. So he reported the first case, 6-month study, And he did studies to show that if you shock the forearm, you shock the penis, in the forearm, nothing changes, whereas in the penis, you notice the figures here change, all the figures here change compared to that forearm, and here, and you see that the forearm here, there's no much change, whereas the penis, the blood flow improved. 1 month later, the blood flow also improved. And the p-value is very good. So he documented everything. And then he did the IIEF, the QEQ, rigid score, shear Q score, and they all improved. So he started selling his machines all over the world. And then I was a believer, so I got the first machine and it's working. So the machine is this size, can you see that? And this is the shocker, they just put it there. You can talk to the patient, it's very, 20 minutes is all over. And notice that 70% of all EDs are actually arteriogenic. So in other words, if you have the machine, you're going to cure 70% of your patients. So it's quite a good number. Then this is how it's done. Alright? And you shock it like that by holding it like that, shock it by the side. And this is the Dornier machine head. You see, they hold it there. There are three areas, the distal, middle, and the proximal part. So I just chose the distal, middle, proximal. Now, how do you do it? 300 shocks per site, 5 sites, 6 sessions, total 9,000 shocks. You do 6 times over a 3-week period, week 1, week 2, week 3, twice a week, twice a week, twice a week. So you rest for 3 weeks, then you check, you find they have improved. Alright? And these are some studies that show you the Rosen score being applied and showing that mild cases, 2 points improve, moderate cases, 5 points improve, severe cases, 7 points improve. This is a erection hardness score assessment showing the erection hardness score improved. And if you do 6 sessions, 82% already cured, you see, for mild and moderate. For severe cases, 37% are cured. And so 12 sessions, you know, additional to make it 12 sessions, you didn't recruit too many more, so it's not worth it. So that's why I stuck to a 6-session protocol. And this is another double-blind study showing that it's a double sham control study showing, can you see the green improving? Shockwave is a green. The placebo is the brown. So you can see it's real, the improvements. But this is a placebo control study. And this is another one study showing, now if a patient is on a PDE5 inhibitor, meaning like Viagra or Cialis,